Lord Jesus, you were sent to build a contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us. God, founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor. Grant that, by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of Exodus. Moses did exactly as the Lord had commanded him. On the first day of the first month of the second year, the dwelling was erected. It was Moses who erected the dwelling. He placed its pedestals, set up its boards, put in its bars, and set up its columns. He spread the tent over the dwelling and put the covering on top of the tent, as the Lord had commanded him. He took the commandments and put them in the ark. He placed poles alongside the ark and set the propitiatory upon it. He brought the ark into the dwelling and hung the curtain veil, thus screening out the ark of the commandments, as the Lord had commanded him. Then the cloud covered the meeting tent, and the glory of the Lord filled the dwelling. Moses could not enter the meeting tent because the cloud settled down upon it. And the glory of the Lord filled the dwelling. Whenever the cloud rose from the dwelling, the children of Israel would set out on their journey. But if the cloud did not lift, they would not go forward. Only when it lifted did they go forward. In the daytime, the cloud of the Lord was seen over the dwelling, whereas at night, fire was seen in the cloud by the whole house of Israel in all the stages of their journey. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, mighty God.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, mighty God.
My soul yearns and pines for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, mighty God.
Even a sparrow finds a home, and a swallow a nest in which she puts her young. Your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, mighty God.
Blessed they who dwell in your house. Continually they praise you. Blessed the men whose strength you are. They go from strength to strength.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord, my God.
I had rather one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I had rather lie at the threshold of the house of my God our church and beyond for accountability, justice, and healing throughout our church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who recently died, Walter Johnson and Geraldine Wise, and for Maida B. Ritterbeck, for whom this Mass is being offered. May all the faithful departed and reunited in glory with Christ, our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that remain deep in the silence of our hearts and minds, for those written in our prayer notes book, and for those who have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment to the initiative. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever faithful God, hear us as we turn to you in our need and hasten to give answer. For we pray this and all things in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread of the offering, fruit of the earth, and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine of God, fruit of the vine and the work of your hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and praise the glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that for our saving of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him,
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
How precious is your mercy, O God. body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
The blood of Christ?
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.